You gotta eat him. Oh, he just fell. Oh,
you know what's about to happen. Oh. All right, everybody. Baron here, and welcome back to Jurassic Park. I will say that I think every time I play a Jurassic game, because it's one of the most iconic lines of all time, but let's be honest. Welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution, the game. Yes, this is going to be Jurassic World Evolution gameplay. I would like to thank a brave young man who fended off dinosaurs himself. His name is the indie game promoter, IGP, one of my buddies. Thank you so much for lending me your footage, because one of the cool things about this game is no matter who, like, plays it, you're going to have a different experience overall, right? Here are the five deaths. We're going to Isla Matanceros, although I want to get to that one up in the upper right, Isla Nublar. But so here we are back again, and things are going well, right? So IGP's footage here is going to be a little bit different than mine. In fact, it's going to be decently different. While I didn't get Triceratops till the very end of my gameplay, he got them relatively early on. And while I kind of seem to focus on dinosaurs battling each other and getting the Ceratosaurus, the carnivore, to escape his cage, you know, I had to manually do that. We're going to get to see what happens when the dinosaurs break out themselves, which is pretty impressive to think about, because, like, one of the main concepts of this game is dealing with the aftermath of what happens when life finds a way. By the way, real quick, here's my buddy Jeff to tell you, you know, if you're new here, what you may want to consider.
Hey, subscribe to Baron.
So, anyway, moving on. Thanks, Jeff. A class act, that guy. It was fun to get to interview him. All right, so the first question is, and this was kind of brought up in a comment that Bismarck brought up in my last video. This is just like Operation Genesis. Yes, I was hoping they would go with that route in the development of this game. Can't wait to play. So, here's the thing. I am going to be covering a lot of Jurassic World Evolution footage and gameplay up until the game is launched, and then I'll be playing it and live streaming it over on the Facebook. But anyway, who would like to see a Jurassic Park Operation Genesis gameplay series launching on the channel? Because JWE don't come out till June the 12th, right? Which is, I think, 10 days before the movie comes out. Oh my gosh, Jurassic World, The Fallen Kingdom, right? The second one, which I'm very excited for. I mean, there's a volcano going off. Very excited to see what happens there. But I wanted to know, you know, who would like to see a JP OG? Look at that. How perfect is that? OG, Original Gangsta, or Operation Genesis. Who would like to see that? Because I did ask that in a recent Forts video, but I feel like this is the better forum to ask you guys if you'd like to see that. Also, if you guys have any questions about the game or, you know, my overall experience, let me know. Because right now we's getting into them dinosaur incubations here. And it's kind of curious to see. Look at this. Look at them. Those are the four dinosaurs that we have right now. However, we do know that there are going to be, as Frontier, the developers of this game, by the way, shout out to Bo and Ed, you guys are amazing. There's going to be 40 to 45 dinosaurs confirmed to be in the game so far. Makes you wonder with, like, maybe the release of the movie, because this game's going to come out 10 days before the next movie. So my belief, my theory, this is pure conjecture, theory, and maybe a bit of optimism, as is usually the case over here on the Baron Von Games channel, would be that there's going to be a lot of content coming out in concert with the next movie. So we're gonna get the game, we're gonna have 10 days. In my thought, I'm like, I got 10 days to beat this game before the next Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom content might come out. I don't know if that's gonna happen, but I mean, it seems to kind of make sense, don't you think? That it would be a very good opportunity to capitalize on from both a business perspective and definitely from, you know, a fan's perspective. Like, we want to experience what we would have just seen with the movie, because you know how the movies come out like Thursdays, you know, they say, oh, it's gonna be out this weekend, but if you really look at it, you can get tickets Thursdays a little early. I'm gonna get me a Thursday ticket for that movie. So 40 to 45 dinosaurs here. We're working on some Gallimimus, them walking giant chickens, which kind of remind me of ostriches in a way.
You know, but that's just me. So here we go. While we're getting through this early part, I want to go over some of the comments that I got in the last video, right? A lot of them were pretty good. Alistair was saying right here, "This is so cool. Please do more and make a few short and a few big episodes. This will be the second large, long-form episode, you know, 40 minutes plus. But I do have some plans and some ideas for some shorter-form videos, like..." Real quick stop. I love the animation that they have, like when you incubate and release a dinosaur out of the hatchery into the wild. Well, you could say it's wild, you could also say it's not very wild, since, you know, you've got, look at those fences in the background, right? And there's the man, the myth, the legend, Dr. Ian Malcolm. He's kind of going to be, you know, that voice on your shoulder, the angel on your shoulder. And then I think, like everybody else, the other three kind of divisional leaders, we've got Kajal Dua leading the science division, Isaac Clement for the entertainment division, and George Lambert, who I worked on in the first episode, or worked with in the first episode, with the security division. This is, I believe, going to be more of the science division, I think is what we're going to see, which is cool. So we're going to see a whole different division entirely working in the game, right? And that's going to be kind of one of the other things, is how do the three play together? Anyway, I do have some ideas for some content with regards to, like, shorter form content. You know, not these giant long Let's Plays, which, as fun as they are, you know, we're gonna want a little bit of variety, because variety is the spice of life. Imagine going to a dinosaur park and only seeing two types of dinosaurs, as opposed to 150 bajillion dinosaurs. No, but, like, here we go. Here's the divisions right here. So we're going to go work with Dr. Kajal Dua in the science division. The first steps. This is so cool because this is stuff I didn't get to see. Now, at the beginning, Dr. Dua.
This is our new...
I'm aware who I'm speaking to, Cabot. I'm Dr. Dua. I run the science division of our operation. Okay, you're going to need to build your reputation in the science division. Not easy with me around, but you'll manage. That means managing our dinosaur population and seeing that they are flourishing.
Is that her walking around right there? My gosh. So, I'm curious, if that's Dr. Dua, what would happen if a dinosaur breaks out and, like, eliminates one of the leading characters? Is that a possibility, and what would happen? Or is she kind of, like, immune? Or would she just be wise enough, right, as a gameplay mechanic, like, oh, she's smart enough to escape the dinosaurs? I don't know, but I'm very curious, because if you think about it, I think that might be Dr. Dua, and I think she is the first person in the park right here, it looks like. I don't see any other staff walking around. No, wait, no, I think I may have seen someone in the other ones. But anyway, so as we get the Expedition Center set up, let's go back. But I wanted to ask you guys, in addition to, like, if you'd like to see JPOG, Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, as a series leading up to the release of Jurassic World Evolution in June, I wanted to see how many of you guys would be in favor of that, because I think that is going to be a lot of fun, and I'm really excited to do that. So, let me know if you'd like to see that happen. So, moving on. Toasted Shoes was saying, "My childhood has returned. The game looks incredible." Doesn't it? Alright, so here's one of those kind of contentious comments that Adam was saying. Now, he was saying, just from the limited he got to see of this game, and not having played it, he was saying, "It's lacking that business or tycoon aspect of the game. Game issue, same issue as Planet Coaster." Now, I think that is definitely premature, and Adam swears it never happens. No, but in all seriousness, I think that's a premature consideration. However, it's potential, it's possible. Is it in the realm of possibilities? Yes. Is it in the realm of probabilities? Yes, but I think to a minimal level.
Allow us to work together to create life. Pure life. If you've been listening to Dr. Malcolm, then you know how important this is to us. And to me. I knew you were my kind of person. Inquisitive, driven, and I knew you couldn't resist this opportunity. So let's get started.
Excellent. So Dr. Dua, I was curious as to why IGP had so many triceratops.
Authentic version of our dinosaurs. That means a complete genome. And I think you are up to the challenge. Don't disappoint.
Now, this is one of the fun parts. I'm curious. Oh, gosh. Cabot always interrupts. I remember this from the first episode. But look at the map of the globe and kind of the dig sites. I'm wondering, will there ever be possibilities that more get discovered, or will you always be aware of them, right? It's something I've been curious about, and I'm wondering how it could play into the game. If there was a possibility of you finding your own, or like kind of sponsoring your own dig sites, and maybe there'd be regions with like percentages of what could happen. Because a lot of time going on these dig sites, you can find just materials that aren't worth anything in terms of dinosaur DNA, you know, and kind of like fulfilling your quest to get perfect genomes for all these dinosaurs. But I don't know, it's a thought, right? But yeah, so going back to the business aspect of it, I think that Frontier's fully aware that while Planet Coaster was considered, you know, a very successful game, that there were those lingering criticisms about the kind of business and management aspect of the game. And when you think about the management aspect side of Jurassic Park, oh, this is, I love it. He went into a little bit of detail there on the five deaths, the five islands you'll be going, is that these dinosaurs are going to be trying to get out at all times. You know, and that is what we're going to see today when you have a dinosaur that is a little bit bigger and a little bit stronger than maybe your containment protocols and your physical containment, the fences you're using. If you don't have the tech and the hardware necessary to keep them dinos in, they gonna get out, right? That being said, I think there's a lot of management just when you consider just, one of the main gameplay mechanics that's going to be in this game is, hey, life finds a way, and you've got to kind of keep life from finding a way in a certain regard. I mean, I'm excited to do that. I'm still kind of blown out of the water by the fact that in this demo that we got to play at the event, there was only four dinosaurs available, and it's going to be absolutely insane. Like, 40 to 45 dinosaurs is an incredibly large number. I'm trying to think about how long it would take me, you know, in a gameplay or live streaming this, you know, in hours, till I have a park that's big enough to hold all of them, and hold all of them at least, I'd say, 80 to 90% adequately, right, in terms of keeping them actually in their cages. If you had two of every dinosaur, or, you know, two to three, you could have over 100 dinosaurs. Do you know how many, like, ranger teams you'd need and helicopter teams you'd need to, like, just deal with the containment protocols when some of these dinos go amok? I'm very curious as to how that's going to be, and I'm very excited to try it out, but 100 dinosaurs in a park. And I remember asking, you know, there's the five deaths, there's the five different islands, and you're going to build parks on all of them. I'm wondering if, like, you may want to theme them, or I even asked the question, like, what if I just wanted to focus on one island and just build the biggest dino park possible? And they said that is possible and that is viable, and you're more than welcome to do that, right? I think it's going to be one of those things where you may want to proceed down the campaign. Look at that. We're going to have a Triceratops. This was the last dinosaur that
we're
I got.
Making great strides so far. I believe I may be on the cusp of something wondrous. And I have you to thank, at least in part, for where I find myself. Now we need to incubate, hatch, and house our dinosaur. Then we will know if our efforts will have been worth it.
So science seems to go straight down to the trikes, and I got the Edmonds, you know, the Edmontosauruses and the Triceratops. So security was Edmontosaurus. I'm wondering if entertainment, that would make sense. Entertainment may have pushed for Ceratosauruses first, because everybody had Gallimimuses to begin with, right? Yeah, I guess going back is, if you think about the dinosaurs we have, we've got Indominus Rexes, Tyrannosauruses, and Velociraptors. There's the Spinosaurus. I'm trying to think if they're... I'm curious about the Mesosaurus. Are we going to be able to get that? And how will you be able to contain it in the park? Are you going to build a giant kind of, like, pond? A giant lake to house it? And I mean, it's got to be saltwater, so it's gonna be, if that comes in the game, the amount of resources you're gonna have to spend on that. And then it's like, will you be able to recreate one of those Jurassic World moments where the Mosasaurus like eats another dinosaur? or eats some of the park people.
Intuitive learning.
It's so funny how, like, I went for more aggressive traits in my DNA splicing. And this is kind of going more of a, you know, a scientific background. You got the octopi here.
Man, so what? Ankylosaurus, Apatosaurus. Oh my gosh, some of these names. Brachiosauruses, obviously. Ceratosauruses, which we've seen. Dilophosauruses, Edmontosauruses. Kentosaurus. The amount of sauruses, the amount of dinosaurs.
And we only know about 26 out of the 40 to 45 so far that people have been keeping up with.
Look at this. Our first Triceratops. How glorious is this thing?
I will say that one of my criticisms, or rather constructive criticisms, naturally, of the game was better camera control, just universally. And I would say that, like, when we played it, that was what? Was that March? I think it was March.
Dinosaurs are meeting expectations, but we want them to thrive. That's your next assignment. Making sure our specimens are properly cared for. In other words, dinosaur welfare.
The difference with dinosaurs is that they have no point of reference to understand humans, so don't expect much in the way of thank yous.
That'd be Ian Malcolm. Jeff Goldblum. 10 out of 10 Goldblums. This game got from him.
I mean, if you think about just the replayability of this game and the different kind of experiences that everybody's going to have. By the way, if my voice sounds a little bit different, I am rocking cough drops right now because I have a cold and a terrible cough. So this is keeping me in the game. Every now and then I might go quiet, and that's mainly because either something cool is happening on screen or I'm about to have a coughing fit. So, Isla Martinsero's profit per minute. It's good to see that I wasn't the only one operating in the red. But I think that was kind of the way it was when you're doing the demo. But it's going to be curious. Like, so, everybody's going to be playing the same game, right? To start. But given that there's three of the different divisions, science, entertainment, and security, and the different ways to go about it, like, you know, some people may go, hey, I'm going straight entertainment. I'm not even going to touch the other two branches. Some people may heavily favor two. Oh, look at the rain there. Dude, I love the feeder that pops the goat up. But, you know, I'm wondering if the best approach would be to try to balance one or go all in on one. I will say that if I'm going to go all in on one, it's probably security. Because I'm really curious about where that ends up. Because one of the themes from Jurassic World was that there was a faction, and I brought this up in the last video as well, and I want to get your thoughts and opinions on it, is what happened in Jurassic World near the end was there was one faction, you know, that wanted to kind of use the raptors for military purposes. So what if I'm going to propose this idea. Now, I have no information, this is pure speculation, and like I said, a little bit of hope. I would love to see that whole kind of expedition center where you go out and go on missions to, you know, get fossils, get those beautiful little mosquitoes locked up in amber with so much DNA, which, you know, historic or in all scientific reality wouldn't have because DNA atrophies, from what I understand. I'm no DNA scientist. I'm no Dr. Ian Malcolm. I'm some guy who's talking on the end of a microphone. But, that being said, it would be cool to have an expedition center with militarized dinosaurs. Imagine that. I mean, okay. I'm gonna go quiet because I'm about to cough. And I'm gonna have a little bit of water because, oh my gosh, I'm getting wrecked. Imagine that. Imagine being able to send out expeditions of different dinosaurs. So, oh, you have a 20% chance of finding Triceratops DNA at this location? Well, militarized dinosaurs. Oh, if you're only sending two trained raptors, you have a 5% chance of success. Oh, you want to send Indominus Rexes or the Indominus Rex Raptor hybrids that you're working on, which are smaller Indominus Rexes? Oh, well, if you're sending seven of those guys, you have a 99% chance of success because those guys are bosses. Wouldn't that? I mean, that's, I don't know. Am I getting a little too ahead of myself? Probably, but that's something I would be looking for. So, as far as characters in the game, we only know of five. Dr. Ian Malcolm, voiced by Jeff Goldblum, obviously. Mr. Cabot Finch, the PR and crisis management handler. And then we've got Cathal Dua. I think it's probably Cathal. Isaac Clement and George Lambert, the three divisional managers. So here we go. Expedition map. I'm very curious if there may be a faction of InGen if you go deep, deep down the security where you can send out militarized dinosaurs or maybe even sell them, right? Like, what if you could auction off dinosaurs? Because there's speculation just off... this is me with my conspiracy theories. I want you to put on your tinfoil hats right now and think about dinosaurs going out on missions. I don't know if you'd actually manage them. They would just... it'd be something you would do as kind of like, you know, and it would be an expedition, right? But there you go. That would give a lot more to the business and management side of the game. But hey, that's me. So a lot of you guys were saying that the game is beautiful, that you just want to see more of it, you know, and I cannot agree with you more. I'm very excited that this is episode 2. I'm so curious about the future of this game. So I've been keeping up with, you know, the dinosaur kind of showcasing, right? Like, now that we know there's 26, I've been trying to think a lot as to what the other 14 to 19 of the 40 to 45 dinos that Frontier said will be in the game. I'm curious as to, like, what some of them are, how many of them are going to be hybrids, because we know we've seen of the hybrid dinosaurs, we know Indominus Rex, and then there's the, what, Stegoceratops, was it? Where it's a Triceratops and a Stegosaurus, which was previewed in the Jurassic World movie on the computer. Will we be able to do that? Like, will we be able to hybridize any of the dinosaurs? Will we be able to hybridize 2 to 3? Because if you think about it, what that would mean is the number of dinosaurs that would end up being in the game would be insane. I mean, you'd be getting in... if you can hybridize them, 40 to 45 dinosaurs just became like, I don't know, hundreds? Would it get up to thousands even? I think so, with the number of variations you could get. But I don't know if that's going to be the thing. Once again, pure theory, conjecture, and a little bit of hope. So here we go. There's the rhodium, which you sell. No DNA present. Amphibian fossils. Oh, look at that. I don't think I got any of those amphibian fossils. I only got dinosaur fossils. So that's always cool to see something that I didn't see. And I, you know, may have seen hours into my gameplay, whereas someone else may have seen it 5 minutes into theirs. That's the kind of thing that I love in a game, is just kind of, you know, and that goes to the whole idea of replayability. I'm wondering if, as far as, like, my approach, like I mentioned earlier, will I go to multiple parks and then focus on one island, where, because what I believe is, and they kind of mentioned it in the game, when you look at the overall map of the different of the five deaths, the five islands, is that there will be different natural disasters and different they're not all natural disasters necessarily, just different weather effects that will affect the difficulty of managing a park on that island. But the game is gonna encourage you to progress down that, so you open up all the different technologies, all the different building upgrades, all the different ways to kind of, you know, splice up and hybridize the genomes of these dinosaurs, as well as unlocking certain dinosaurs. Like, I'm pretty sure that to get, I don't know, I think it was the T-Rex, you had to get to the third island, maybe? There was definitely one of the dinosaurs in the first gameplay that I did where I saw, like, oh, I'm not going to be able to get that till... it said get to Isla Pena, maybe? I think it was the third island. And once you did get access to that island, you could, you know, proceed down what you had to do in order to unlock it. Could you work with one division on one island exclusively and then work with another division on another island exclusively and thereby have good relations with all three divisions and have three completely different themed or, you know, leaning towards parks? Like, this one is the military park. This is where we train raptors for combat. I'm curious about that kind of stuff. There's another Triceratops. Now we're gonna be getting into the good stuff real soon. We're gonna get to see dinosaurs escaping. Oh my gosh, man. The individual roars, you know, and noises that the dinos make is going to be awesome. Disease contracted.
You've got a sick dinosaur on your hands. It's time to treat it. Or what comes next, that's going to be on your hands as well.
AKA the dinosaur probably going to go bye-bye. So here we go, the ranger station. You can medicate them. So what if you send a ranger into, you know, an enclosure where there's highly dangerous and aggressive, you know, carnivorous dinosaurs? What happens then? And this is kind of cool because whereas I didn't get a sick dinosaur, which was the Triceratops, by the way, near the end of my gameplay, here we are halfway through, and we're already getting a sick dinosaur. So once again, the different, you know, things that happen. Look at this, getting to drive this thing. I took this thing and I was like ramping on stuff. It was awesome. I do like that you're able to drive this around. Now, I don't think it's going to be like Grand Theft Auto where you can just run over everybody. They will try to like move out of the way here. And I think they're meant, hopefully it could be a little more frantic moving around, but at the same time, this game is not about you driving around in a Jeep or a helicopter and running over people. This game, that doesn't mean your people won't be threatened. This is a game about dinosaurs escaping and them threatening, you know, the denizens of your park, the people who work there, as well as the people who are visiting just to see cool dinosaurs. Now, I was not aware that you could just ride up to the gate and it would open. I thought you had to manually open it yourself. That is pretty cool. So there's the sick trike, and we're gonna have to... Oh, and look at that. You can also resupply the feeder. Hello there, beautiful. This is where you break out your Australian accents, no matter how terrible they are, like mine. Hello, beautiful. I'm gonna shoot you right in the butt with a dart. Yeah, get him right in the thigh there. Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Look at that. It's gonna be interesting, like, some of the bigger dinosaurs, I'm wondering if they're gonna take, like, 5 different darts. Right? Or if you can upgrade your ranger to the point where, like, his dart is so potent you could knock dinos out, but maybe it's so potent it could really harm the smaller ones? I don't know. Mission complete! $1,000,000! Cardio strength 2.0.
We are on the path. Tell me, Dua. To a pure strain dinosaur. This will definitely shift the paradigm. I can't ignore this accomplishment. With your help, obviously. That goes without saying. But under my direction. I think we make a good team. Let's do this again. I'll let you know when.
There we go. So, proceeding down the different divisions' tracks, you know, doing what they ask you, unlocks everything. So, I think there's going to be enough progression to make this... I'm wondering how many hours of content just normally there would be if you just kind of went the story mode route. Because it does seem with everything to unlock and all the different options, sending people out on expeditions, 40 to 45 dinosaurs, hybrid dinosaurs. But that's the question. This is the key question, I think, for the in trying to answer how many total dinosaurs will there be. If there's 40 to 45, if those include the hybrid dinos, then we know that there's going to be limitations set to us as far as what dinosaurs we can hybrid. Now, I will say that while I played this game, a lot of this is just me, you know, putting my questions out into the universe. I'm curious about these things as well. I do not have the answers. I'm just the guy who got, you know, one of the people who got... Oh, the fence is broken. Here's the key thing. This is awesome. This did not happen in my gameplay. So what happened here was a Triceratops broke the fence himself. I don't know if he kind of like rammed it with his head or probably used that big, you know, rear section. He's a big trike there to kind of, look at that, repairing the fence. And now this Triceratops, which is looking like he's moving pretty quick, is running amok in the park. So while I opened the gate and let out a Ceratosaurus, here you can see the Triceratopses just did it themselves. And I'm sure that probably has to do with, you know, the quality of fencing that was used. But if you have all your dinosaurs in one enclosure, which is going to be crazy because it's going to be the Dino Battle Dome. Look at that. I love seeing this giant dinosaur running around out there. So we're going to have to get more power plant coverage here. I believe. Too steep. Oh, there it is. Nice. No power.
Uh-oh.
That ain't good, friend. The power output needs to be upgraded. See, once again, this is something that I did not encounter. So, if you have some of the more dangerous dinosaurs and you have electrified fences, then when something like that happens, that's going to be terribly, terribly inconvenient and will definitely make you vulnerable for a dinosaur outbreak, right? Or dinosaur breakout. Speaking of outbreaks, there are going to be diseases, right? Now, we know that there's four been mentioned so far that the dinosaurs are going to have, not the park people. There's going to be the common cold, which I am suffering from right now, and it sucks. There's going to be hookworm. There's going to be something called the Campylobacter bacteria and bracken poisoning. Oh, look at this, the trike battle mites. See, and this is just where, like, better camera controls would definitely, you know, even better the overall feel and experience of the game. Okay, so they kind of were like, hey, mate, we both escaped. Let's not fight amongst each other. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Let's go eat all the plants and run around on all this new territory. Or, you know, if dinosaurs could talk. But so the power's going to need to be put on. I wonder if the door, if a door's left open and the power goes out, will the door be stuck there until you have the power to, or will there be manual controls?
A contract just landed on my desk. You need to take a look.
Hatch, three new dinosaurs. All right, so there we go.
This is Lambert, head of security.
Yours, theirs, and mine. Welcome to the islands. So here's our basic conundrum. We want to keep our animals under control while simultaneously encouraging instinctive behaviors, because these animals have potential as combatants. Look, everyone's fear object, myself included, is to have these animals running free and loose in the park. But we can't exploit them globally without taking some chances.
Well, there we go. I thought Dr. Ian Malcolm in mind was like, oh yeah, this guy's great. He sounds like he's smart. And then, you know, Lambert did something else. He's like, oh, I don't know about this guy. Which was pretty funny. But once again, kind of going to the point of being able to go down three different divisional trees. Didn't have to do that, but for $100,000, would you turn it down? Got to connect the paths and then the power lines. Pretty cool. So, I don't know. I just really like how even through this, it's in experiencing something that I didn't experience, like Triceratops breakouts, power going out. I don't think I had a power outage maybe till the very last moment of my gameplay. And I didn't have a sick dinosaur till the very, very end. That was kind of like the last thing that we did was the power going out. And someone mentioned, where was it? It's like, oh, look at this technology of the power plant. Yeah, Vire. I'm surprised how high-tech the game by using power line with pole instead of underground cable. Well, I'm sure there's probably that technology, but also from a visual standpoint, you'd want to be able to see the power. Look at that. Strothiomimus has escaped as well. Everybody's getting out. I think because the power went out and maybe the gates open would be my guess. Because I'm fairly certain that the Rangers repaired it. Look at all the dinos hanging out here. This is great. Hello there, Govna. Are they fighting or are they talking like hanging out like bros? I think since they're both herbivorous, you know, I don't think they would fight. But yeah, man. See, it was kind of funny. Like, you got to get your helicopters out here to subdue them. You could use Rangers to trank them and then get those helicopters going. But should be interesting to see, you know, how this is dealt with. ACU copter. Yeah, no, not pilot it. Add the tech. Yeah. But being able to pilot it to different vehicles obviously adds a little bit extra fun. It's not something you need to do. You can pilot themselves or you can just have them send them out automatically. I wonder if it's like one of those key tasks. I'm wondering, actually, that brings up a question. If it's a key task, the AI might do it better than you will. You know, they might not miss a dart. Or I'm wondering if in certain cases you would perform better. Look at this. You would perform better than the AI. Look at that guy running, man. How are you gonna... Oh, and there's drop and arc to the shot here. Oh, there we go. There it is. Oh, he's running. This is so fun. Oh, that was close. That almost was an excellent shot. And look at all those people running off the path into the forest nearby as a result of these dinos breaking out. Oh my god, that would have been Kobe. And then you got three of them in Trank. But I'm fairly certain that you can send rangers, but I don't think anyone has done it. I didn't do it. Navigating that helicopter near the power lines. There we go, got one's down. So now you gotta get the other helicopter, the big Sikorsky helicopter. Look at all these people, man, all those scientists. Will you have to use the ACU, team? Collecting asset. Or would you also be able to use rangers if the dinosaur's small enough? Or could you have vehicle upgrades? I think that's a pretty key question. Because it may, like, that's what I'm saying. This is when you get to the point of later down the road when you've got, you know, 20, 40, 100 dinosaurs. How many of these helicopters would you need? Or wait a minute, is that three right there? This may be answering the question right here. Look at this. Yeah, see? If the camera controls were just a tad bit more optimized, which I'm hoping they do. Yeah, okay. There we go. So, I actually would like that to change, personally. My vote, here we go. This is a pretty key question for you guys as well. Would you rather have to have the amount of helicopters on hand or the amount of centers? Say the center came with two potential lifting helicopters. Otherwise, just being able to airlift like 20 dinosaurs at once seems a little cheap. You know, a little unfair to me. Otherwise, you'd only need one, you know? And I think that would go to a critique on the whole management aspect of the game. But look at that, three dinosaurs going down simultaneously. This is just beautiful is what that is. Look at that. Now all the people are getting back to normal. Oh, there's the helicopter. See, I think most of us experienced, like, just if we just had a little bit better camera controls, the amount of epic moments you could capture, as well as, you know, great screenshots as well, and just overall atmosphere of the game would definitely be increased. So, while I kind of rushed the dinos, and I got three, here we've got a Ceratosaurus here. Incubate the dinosaur eggs. You see, when you look around, how much of this island could you build on? Because I know there's also mountains in the way as well. Park management and overall planning is going to be very interesting. With the mountains, with the different bodies of water, with the different elevations of the terrain, you're going to have to really plan ahead, I think. Especially your pathways and sizes of your enclosures. Here we go, close the gate. And now, oh my gosh, he's made the enclosure. He is encouraging his dinosaurs to escape. That's one of the things. You could create absolute anarchy on one of your parks if you wanted to. All right, we've got 200 dinosaurs, all carnivorous, and we've got 50,000 people visiting. Now we are releasing all of them at the same time. Oh my gosh, what would that be like? I've also mused about the idea of having like gladiators, like dinosaur gladiators. It would be cool if you could control the dinos as well. I wonder if that'll ever be a mod or if that'll ever be in the game at all. But I sure hope so. Because that was one of the cool things about Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, and granted it's an older game, was the modding that people have done for that. Like, you can play Jurassic World Operation Genesis, you know, where you've got the dinosaurs and the different skins and the different look and feel of the parks and stuff like that. This is a question I have for y'all. Science, entertainment, or security? I think I did a poll, but I'm curious to know which is the division that you most likely see yourself being able to relate to. Clean or easy, but it is always necessary. So look this contract over. This is so funny. Gallimimus running around here. Obstruciomimus running around. Scaring everybody off, dude. But imagine how fast you'd be running if you saw a T-Rex coming. But yeah, that's actually one of the questions I have is, like, being able to send three helicopters out to raise the dinosaurs when you only have one center and one of each is something I'm curious about. Or did they just come off from off-screen? They kind of seem like they did come off from off-screen, didn't they? But I don't know. I can't confirm that. That's something that's definitely a big question for me. See, because this one takes off from the helipad. I think you only have one of these.
And this is the one that has kind of more... I mean, he's going to be the one that has to put these dinosaurs to sleep, right? But we have seen in the trailer that a Triceratops specifically, and that's what happened in this game as well, the Triceratops specifically are more than capable of getting out of these kind of like... I mean, realistically, it's just a low-tier fence. And I think that what I remember is like, I know there's light, and then there's big, and then I think there's electric. I'm wondering if there's more than that. Could you also use moats and things? Like, you know when you go to the zoo and you see like the tiger cage, there's a small fence, and then there's like a big cliff with a moat around it. So it's like the tiger would have to swim through the moat and then climb 10 feet and then get over like a 1 to 2 foot fence. The fence is really just to keep the people from getting into the animal enclosure, and the elevation change and the moat itself is what keeps the animal out of where the viewers are, right? You think we'll have that? But then again, that would you could definitely keep dinosaurs from breaking out. And I don't think that's the point of this game. The point isn't like, oh yeah, I'm going to 100% keep these dinosaurs in. The point really is, I mean, it just goes back to the original, life finds a way. There will always be, I think there's never going to be a perfect defense for these dinosaurs. And if someone comes up with it, like I guess you could have like 3 different fences, right? That would be interesting. Then that could buy you time. I mean, you could have a very good one. I think you'd have like 99% security, but that would be so expensive, right? I bet you could do that. Because like when you look at this one right here, you've got like 2 fences right there. And that kind of got me thinking, you could have different sets of gates. It could be viable. There's a possibility of it. Now, I wonder if you could lure dinosaurs, you know, to get them to go down like kind of like certain routes. I've got to say, overall, Jurassic World Evolution is, you know, one of the top games I'm looking forward to in 2018. I cannot wait for June 12th. It was kind of fun to see a different style of gameplay going down a different branch. In episode 1, if you haven't seen it, highly encourage you to check that out. We mostly worked with George Lambert. See, him getting the Ceratosaurus near the end from working with the science division was similar to me working with George Lambert of the security division and getting Ceratosaurus earlier, but getting Triceratops right near the end. Oh, I love it. Look how scary that thing is. And that is just a Ceratosaurus. That's not a Tyrannosaurus. That's not Indominus Rex. And we've got a dinosaur battle going on. There's a dinosaur attack. Oh, that's because the gate's open. So he's going to simply walk straight out the open gate, and look at that group of people. They gotta run, man. Spread out! They're coming! Oh no. Is that Dr. Dua? Really, dude? Oh no. You gotta eat him? Oh, he just fell! Oh! You know what's about to happen. Oh. Oh my gosh! And there it is. And there it is. To quote the great Jeff Goldblum, Dr. Ian Malcolm's character, the Ceratosaurus has eaten a park person. So there it is, boys and girls. Welcome to Jurassic World Evolution. Let me know what you'd like to see in the next episode. Longer form, shorter form, and I'll see you there.